What we're going to do is we're going to start by finding our placement. We're going to do our circle first. When we want to do our circle, we want to make sure that we try and center it so we don't have more space on one side than we do on the other side. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to let it come down closer to the bottom here. So that way I can have a little trail of fire kind of coming away. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw my circle first. I want to think about if I just give myself little marks where they're about the same. That way I know not to go farther out than this and farther out than this. And that's about equal. And then I'm just going to do the same thing down here. And that's just going to kind of be my guide. So I just got, you got a little space here, a little space here, and a little space here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start, and you're not going to connect these, okay? These are just a guide so that we don't go out of the lines. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by building my circle. And what I want to make sure that I do is that I keep it round. I don't want it to be flattened anywhere. As I go. And this is going to take a couple of times around, I'm sure, because drawing a circle is not the easiest of things. And if you want, you can even find something to trace. That might help you get your circle. But you can see right here. See how it flattened to a point? So I want to go ahead and I want to straighten that out. It should be nice and round. And then wherever you want, you can go ahead and kind of erase so that you can see your lines a little bit better. Don't put your eraser, like if I erase on here and then I dump it down, it's going to go right into my paint. So I want to be cautious that I'm not getting too crazy here. Go ahead and I'm going to round these edges as best as I can. And as always, as long as we're trying our best, we have something to be proud of. And since we're doing this freehand, we have to remember that it isn't going to be perfect, and that's okay. And if you're tracing it, that's okay too. So take your time and really focus on getting that circle the best that you can. And just keep playing with it until you feel like it's where you want it to be. So I feel pretty good about this circle right now. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to focus on the pentagon shape that you typically find on a soccer ball. And what I need to do is I need to start by just drawing a pentagon. Now, I don't want to draw it too big. I don't want to draw it too small. So I kind of want to think about how big that pentagon would be on a soccer ball if I saw it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to have one full pentagon in the center, and then I'm going to have partial pentagons kind of coming around the edges, and they're all going to kind of connect. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to start with drawing my first pentagon. So it's got kind of that triangle top, and then it's going to have the angles, and then a straight line across like this. Okay, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to start going around the sides. So I'm just going to do partial pentagons around the sides, and I'm going to kind of line them up using this pentagon as my guide. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to think about how this is going to connect to the next one. So I gave myself a little guide, and so this corner is going to do the same thing. So I've got my triangle top, then it's going to angle in on my side, and then this is my flat bottom, like that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this corner, and I'm going to give myself that little guide again, and I'm rounding that line so that it makes the soccer ball look round. and I'm gonna try and make it about the same size as this one so that it's consistent. And with this one, I'm gonna go my triangle top and keep it pretty easy here. Come in on my angle and that flat bottom right there. So we've got that. We're gonna go over to this one and it's gonna be the same thing. Go to the same width that I can. Now on this one, I'm gonna start going kind of the opposite. I'm gonna do my triangle top to that corner, I'm gonna angle in, and I'm gonna do my flat bottom. And then I'm gonna come over here. I'm gonna continue this line right here. And I'm again trying to keep it consistent with the length. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna do that triangle top. That corner is gonna come right to there. It's gonna angle in. And again, if you look and you follow this line, that should all cut through the center of that pentagon. These ones should all line up with the bottoms. And then these corners are gonna line up with these corners. And then last but not least, I'm gonna do one more up top. I'm gonna go ahead, do my triangle top, my angle in, and the flat bottom. So that's our basic soccer ball shape that we've got going here so far. And then what we're gonna do is, just for fun, we can go ahead and we can make a little fire coming out the back here. And so I'm gonna go to the outer edge of the ball, and I'm gonna start just by making these two lines. And then when you think of fire, you think of those flames, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna draw those flames like that. So we just kind of came out, came to a point, came back in, and we just keep making that jagged line like that. And then you can kind of follow a similar for a second row on the inside if you wanted to. And the other thing is, if you didn't want to do the fire, you could always personalize your soccer ball, and you could leave the fire out and you could put your name across the top or your number, whatever you want to do. So now that we've got the soccer ball drawn, what we want to do is we want to start painting. I'm going to paint my background first, and I'm going to use my biggest brush. And for this background, we're going to go ahead and we're going to give it a green background. You guys can use whatever color you want, but I'm going to go ahead and do green. I'm going to start by mixing my color. So I'm going to take a little bit of yellow and a little bit of blue. And I'm going to mix them together until I get the green that I like. I'm going to add a little bit more in here. And I'm going to just take a little bit of white, and I just want to lighten it up just a little bit. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that mixture, and I'm just going to spread it on. I'm going to keep this nice and simple, and I'm just going to keep it a straight green. I'm not going to do anything fancier since we've got the fire. That's fancy enough for me. So I'm just going ahead, and I'm just pulling that paint around and making sure that there's no thick lines of paint or anything like that. If there are, you want to make sure to spread those out so that they don't drip down your canvas and cause you trouble later. So I'm going ahead and I turned my brush sideways and I gave myself a little outline. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull that paint away from there. It makes it a little bit easier to paint with this bigger brush without having to go into those tiny spaces. But again, I want to make sure that any of those thick lines of paint I pull out. That'll make it quicker for this to dry, which will make it easier for us to paint the next part on. And I'm going to keep turning my canvas so that it's easier for me for the angle that I'm at to go ahead. And again, I'm going to give myself that outline. I'm going to go ahead and pull that paint away. I'm going to be aware of where I hold my canvas, because as I fill in this background, I'm going to keep turning my canvas, and as I fill it in, I don't want to stick my hand in wet paint and leave myself a fingerprint. So I want to be careful with where I hold it. So now I'm holding it in the fire, so I'm not grabbing onto anything that's wet. And when I get up to those flames, I'm just very carefully going in there. If you feel more comfortable using a smaller brush and getting in there with a smaller brush, you can absolutely do that. It's important that you do what's ever comfortable for you to make sure that you get the coverage that you want. And then as I come around here, like I said, I'm going to be cautious of where I hold it. So now I'm holding it on the soccer ball. And I'm just filling this last spot, and I've got to mix just a smidge more paint. When I mix more paint, it's important to keep the original color on my plate where I can see it, so that as I mix more, I can see that I've actually matched up the right color. And again, I'm going into those flames here. So I'm just being very careful, but if you want to go ahead and switch out to a smaller brush, you can absolutely do that. Just getting the last couple spots in here. And then I'm going to look at it, and I'm going to make sure that I've got no thick lines of paint or anything of the sort. And that way it'll dry nice and clean. I want to make sure that my line is pretty good around here. It doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to be using other colors. But I do see like a little bit of a white spot in around here. And so I do want to go back through and cover that up just a little bit, so I don't regret not doing it later, especially when you mix colors. It's hard to find those colors again, so it's important that when you're mixing colors, you use what you need. Okay, so I'm going to put that down, and I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to rinse out this brush. And when I rinse it out, I'm going to tap it around on the bottom of the cup. Really get that paint out. If you swirl it, some of the paint will come out, but it won't come out as well. So I'm going to really tap it around on the bottom of that cup. I'm going to wipe it on the sides of my cup, and then I'm going to dry it off really, really good with the paper towel. Also make sure as you're drying it off that you're drying off all of up here too. You want to make sure there's no sudden drips that come in. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to start painting the soccer ball, which means I'm going to go ahead and I'm gonna hold it by the fire so that way I can hold it without smudging my painting. So I'm dipping right into my white, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna come up to this pencil line right here, and these, like all of these pencil lines, I'm gonna come right up to, but I'm not gonna paint over them. I want to remember where they are. So So what I'm going to do is see how I come right up to them, but I don't actually paint over them. I know that's kind of hard to see because painting white on white is kind of trickier, I know. But it's just, if you do paint over it, it's not the end all. It's okay. It's just, it'll make it easier for you as we go to do another part. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fill all of these areas in. I'm using that biggest brush again. I'm being careful because I can see that I've got that green line right there and I don't want it to smear into my soccer ball. So I want to be super duper careful. So if you see that, you want to go real slow. You want to be careful. If that green paint does come in, just go ahead, take a clean paper towel and kind of wipe that paint away a little bit. Be very careful. Only use what you need to. And then once it's wiped away and it's nice and dry, then you can go ahead and you can paint over it again. Now, if I look at this angle, I can see where I've painted white and where I haven't. So you can angle yours so that you can kind of tell where it's been done and where it hasn't. And that kind of just helps me to be able to see. Because we want to make sure, I know it seems silly to paint white on white, but it is important that we finish the canvas. So every time I come up to that pencil line, I'm going right up to it, but I'm not painting over it. But no worries, if you already have, you'll be able to find it again. Oops. So, I just painted over the pencil that I didn't mean to. So what I'm going to do, so I'm just going to take my thumb and wipe that away, and now I can see that line again. All right. Again, I want to have a nice clean line. So I'm going to try to go real slow, real careful, so that I get that nice clean line. Now I'm noticing something happening, and I want to show you guys just in case it happens to you. If you look at my brush, you can see that there's colors kind of dripping down, which means there was water still stuck up in there. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rinse this off more because I don't want any of those colors to get onto my white right now. So I'm going to give it a good rinse and dry it off really good again. And that's going to make sure that doesn't happen. So I want to go back through, and again, I'm going to angle this around so I can see kind of where I painted, where I haven't. Some of the spots are dry now, which is good. So it may look like I haven't painted it, but I really, really have, and I can tell, you'll be able to tell what's dry and what actually hasn't been painted. I'm going to smooth out any of my edges that I feel like I need to. And I want to, again, make sure that I don't have any thick lines of paint or big drips anywhere or anything. And then once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rinse out this brush again real nice. I'm going to dry it off. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start working on the pentagon shapes in here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my smallest brush, and to make it easier on myself, the way that you use this brush is that you're going to roll it into the paint so that all of your bristles kind of stick together here. And then what I'm going to do is the harder that I press, the wider the line, the softer that I press, the thinner the line. And so for this, I'm not worried about the thickness of the line as long as I'm inside the line. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to give myself this little outline here. So I'm not going to fill in with this brush because that would take a longer time and chances are I would end up kind of scratching the brush everywhere and then it might ruin it. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to give myself that outline. And then that makes it a little bit easier for me to take my medium brush, dip into the black, and fill that in without having to worry that I'm going to go onto the white. Now again, you still have to be careful, but it'll make it a little bit easier for you. So I'm going to go ahead and fill that in like that. And then I'm going to do that to each one around here. Make sure that your paint is dry where you're holding it. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do the same thing. Now, because it's not going to take me that long and I'm using straight black, what I can do is I can outline all of them and then just fill in afterwards. Sometimes you don't want to do that depending on the colors that you're using and if you're blending and all that good stuff. But for something like this where it's just a straight color, we can go ahead and do that. And it shouldn't give us a problem. Careful where you stick that hand. I'm going to go ahead and wipe off my hand. Make sure that I didn't smudge the center here. You can see a little bit, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to push that paint around to kind of cover that. Then I'll go back to it, make sure my hand is nice and dry. Always got to be aware of wet paint. And then the last one here. Gotta be careful of where I'm going. All right, I'm going to go ahead and rinse out this brush. Get nice and cleaned off there. I'm going to go back to my medium brush and fill these spots in. Now again, I'm using my medium brush, but I want to make sure that I don't have too much paint on it where all of a sudden it's going to drip or anything. So I'm going to get some of this extra off. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back, so I can see a thick line of paint. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I can see a thick line of paint right here. Just going to spread that out a little bit more. It's going to help it dry. just like that. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rinse this brush out. Get it nice and clean. I'm going to go back with my smaller brush. Now what I'm going to do is I want to kind of trace these lines now. Instead of having them be pencil, I want them to be paint. But what I want to do is I want to make like a light gray. I don't want it to be too dark, which means the black goes really, really far and it will overpower your white. So what I want to do is I want to take my white, and I don't need a ton, but I'm going to take some white here and I'm going to put it on my plate. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take just the smallest amount of black. It's barely on there. You can barely see it. And I'm going to mix it right in. And as I mix it, you'll see it already turned. And I barely used any. And you can tell how much white I've got there. So you don't want it to be too dark. Then I don't want so much paint on my brush. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to really rinse that off and get it nice and dry and ready. Make sure this brush is cleaned up too while I'm here. And then what I'm going to do is, again, I want to be cautious of where I touch on my canvas here, but I'm going to take that light gray and I'm just going to trace right over that pencil in each spot. And if you lost one of your lines, just remember it's from corner to corner. And then what I'm going to do, I'm not going to give a full outline to the soccer ball, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to give a little accent there on the edges. And again, with this brush, remember the harder you press, the wider the line. So if you want it thinner, you want to lighten up on how hard you're pressing. If you want it wider, you want to press a little bit harder. And there we go. So we've got that going. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to put some accents on. Oh, I didn't dry it off. I'm going to rinse this off again here. Dry it off completely. And then I'm going to put some accents on my soccer ball here. So I'm going to take that white. My black should be dry by now, or at least mostly. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow the line right there. And then I'm going to put another line right like that. And then one more line right like that. And I'm going to do it on each black spot. Just a couple as we go around here. Oops. Like like that. So the next thing we're going to do is we are going to go ahead and we're going to start painting that fire. And so I'm going to start with my biggest brush. And I'm going to go ahead and fill in this part closest to the ball. I'm going to go ahead and turn my brush sideways so I can get that angle going. And I'm going to rinse out this brush. I'm going to dip into my yellow. I'm going to turn that brush sideways again. Now again, if you feel more comfortable using a smaller brush, go ahead and do that. I'm not going to worry if my yellow and my red mix a little bit. That's not going to bother me. Just because that'll just blend to an orange, which will actually make a nice little accent. Normally, I would say you don't want to go right up to a color unless you're intending for it to blend. And so it's up to you. If you don't want it to blend, then you want to wait for that color to dry completely. And if you do want it to blend, then you can go ahead and do it while it's wet and even mix a little together on purpose if you want. Make sure you fill in all those white spots there. So take the time. And then what you're going to do is you're going to check everything out. You're going to look it over. You're going to decide if you want to change anything, make it bigger, make it smaller, whatever you want to do. There's a couple things that you can still play with here. And then you want to make sure you clean those brushes out. Get them all nice and dried off so that they're ready to go for next time. And that's it.